All right, gentlemen, take your seats. Let's get this over before lunch. Clyde Rose of the Homicide Squad has decided to take early retirement. We will all miss Floyd and the steely edge he brought to his police work. The department has arranged a wee drink at the Galway Arms to quench the mighty thirst a man gets from 25 years of police work. Floyd's departure leaves a place at the top table, and the chief has seen fit to promote Cole Phelps from burglary to the homicide desk. Stand up, Phelps. Take a chair. You're in the major leagues now, Sonny. Rusty Galloway, a fine lawman of the old school, will be taking you under his wing. Your first case is the murder of a woman found last night and bearing all the signs of the werewolf. Get out to the scene, lads.
He plays a saxophone, and boy, can he get me going. Say, whatever happened to that fella?
Do you have the address?
It's been all over KGPL. It's off Temple Street.
Herman's Belmont.
Printer by trade.
You know the way. You can drive.
How about a scoop for the Examiner, Galloway? You could use some good press.
Another tramp, another message. Is the werewolf back in business, boys?
Do you have a mother, asshole? A sister? How about showing some respect for this poor woman? Let us do our job, and Detective Galloway will give you a statement later.
He's good, Rusty. He even sounds genuine.
That's Phelps, guys. The war hero. Defending the honor of murdered humps.
Get used to it, Phelps. Move along, guys. You got your pictures, you got your headlines. Now scram.
Patrolman, this your beat?
Yes, sir. Well, part of it. Kids park here, they use it like a lover's lane. It's a working neighborhood. Some trouble, but nothing like this. It's known locally as the Moors.
You were first on the scene?
Yes, Detective.
No one's disturbed the body?
No, sir. We cleared out them vulture reporters so Pinker and the coroner could work. They're waiting to talk to you.
Go house to house and see what you come up with. Brothers.
Phelps. You make homicide?
Looks like it. Galloway has been making me feel welcome.
I bet he has.
Has the scene been secured?
Patrolman Houlihan saw to it. The victim's personal effects are still where they fell.
Cause of death?
Could be the head injuries. She has been badly stomped.
What caused the blunt force injury to the face?
Could be anything from a baseball bat to a lug wrench. I'll have more details after the autopsy.
What about this wound on the finger?
Something removed, a ring most likely. I assume it was taken post-mortem.
Interesting.
What does the writing on the victim mean?
BD. Like Dahlia? Tex? Your guess is as good as mine. Could be something to it, or it could be the killers trying to throw you off the scent. Either way, I'll run tests on the lipstick.
Any idea of the time of death?
From the temperature, I'd say after midnight. I'll confirm with you later.
What can you tell me about the shoe prints?
Men's size 8s. Pinker lifted impressions for me to compare back at the lab.
The victim's bag? Looks brand new. Can't be the one used on the body. Looks like some kind of puzzle or parlor game. The Bomba Club. Why steal a table lighter?
When we get to the Bomba, a man could die of thirst in a case like this.
You can drive. Gentlemen, what can I get you?
Phelps and Galloway, LAPD. Were you working here last night?
Yes. How can I help, officer?
You can start with your name.
Garrett Mason.
You're the regular bartender on nights?
I'm a temporary barman. I work for an agency. I fill in at bars across town.
Do you remember a woman who came in here last night? 5'7", about 110 pounds, blonde hair, about 40 years of age.
You mean Celine Henry?
Yes. Do you know anything about her?
I don't. But the owner, Mr. McCall, serves her most nights. Would you like to speak to him?
I would.
He sits at the back of the club. Wears a hibiscus. You can't miss him. Is there anything else?
Wire away, Phelps. I'll stay here.
Detective Phelps, LAPD. We're investigating the murder of Celine Henry. Do you know her?
Celine? Sure, I know her. She and I and Jacob, her husband, we go way back.
She was here last night?
Sure, she's a regular. Celine is... was a lovely woman.
Was Mrs. Henry here with anyone last night?
Not at first. Celine already had quite a head start.
But she attracted attention?
Certainly. A few gentlemen became very enamored with her and her stories. One guy in particular.
You know him?
No. He's been in a couple of times.
Did they leave together?
Yes, at around 11. If it helps, I made the guy's license plate.
I think this could be a great help, sir. Thank you. Mrs. Henry appeared to be missing a ring, torn from her finger, but not her wedding finger.
Celine always wore a red garnet ring on the large side. Larger than life, like Celine herself.
Did she have it a long time?
Sure. Since way back in her flying days.
Did her husband buy it for her?
No, it was before Jacob.
I think you know where the ring came from, and I think you're gonna tell me.
Okay. I bought it years ago. I carried a torch for Celine in those days. Guess I always have. Her old man never knew about it.
You know the husband?
Sure I know Jacob. He was in the Corps. He met Celine on a furlough and married her when the war was finished. Put up with a load of shit.
Do you think he killed his wife?
No. No, not in my opinion.
So if it wasn't Jacob, then you probably let her out of here with the guy who killed her. How do you feel about that?
Stole the attitude, will you? I tried to get onto Jacob. I rang him up, asked him to come pick her up like usual. But he refused. And she picked some night to push him over the edge. I rang him back around 11:30, but Got no answer.
Thanks, Mr. McColl. You've been a big help. One more thing. Would you have an address for Celine?
142 North Union Avenue. God knows I had to send her home in enough cabs to remember that.
Let's get out of here.
Hey, what's the hurry? My stool is just starting to warm up nicely.
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need a registered owner on a license plate, 2BOY8899.
Yes, Detective. I'll need to contact the DMV. Shall I relay the details via KGPL?
Please. Thanks, ma'am.
You want a tip? Refill my coffee next time.
You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
I'll try the back door. Wait here a second. Side window's been jimmied. Looks like somebody's creeped the joint.
You said I had to go back, Doctor.
Fires are cathartic. They allow you to confront your past.
You said the house would be empty.
Are you taking the medication I have prescribed?
You said the house would be empty. I heard them screaming.
Circumstances were unfortunate. My colleagues had made all the necessary arrangements.
You said the house would be empty. You're killing me!
The deaths were unfortunate. But you have dealt with death before.
I want you to come to the clinic and we can deal with
it. You said the house would be empty! How can I find-